Welcome back for the online class. We'll continue from the previous class. We were discussed on morphological image processing. In previous class, we discussed on the basic technique is most used for the morphological process is erosion and the dilation. The erosion is just, in the simple words, we can say it is a is a purpose for image thinning, means we are erasing the boundary of the image. In dilation, we are for the purpose of image thickening, means the edges of the image will be get thick. I shown with the example also with the necessary image. Now let us consider the next algorithm is opening and closing. These are all basic algorithms are based on the fundamentals of erosion and dilation. As I given, okay, if I mention with a circle and a hyphen, it is considered as a erosion technique. If there is a circle with a plus, it will be considered as a dilation technique. Okay, that is your thickening and the thinning. Now let us consider with the opening. It will smoothens the contours, okay, and fuses narrow breaks and long thin curves. It is a basic operation we are performing on an image. If there is like any edges will be there, that will be get get removed out. Means you will find gulfs or kind of like any sharp edges will be there, that will be removed out, and it will make a curves will be available in the image. For which when we are operating with for the corresponding algorithm. Okay, this is a basic equation we'll see. Okay, now the symbol of opening will be like a whole circle. Okay, if A and B, A is considered as a image, B will be your structuring element. Okay, on which you are performing a structuring element operation on A. Okay, which operation you are performing? That is an opening operation. Okay, O will be considered as a opening. Okay, now this is what the equation has been given for the opening. A O, that is a empty O, B is equal to A. Okay, the very first operation we are performing with respect to the structuring element is erosion. And whatever the outcome of the image on which we are performing a dilation by using a structuring element. Okay, I hope you can see. First you perform erosion, A eroded B, and outcome whatever is comes out on which we are performing a dilation by using a structuring element. This is what the basic equation will be used. Now let us consider an image. Okay, let us consider image by looking onto the example. Now there will be like a triangle. Okay, I hope you can see with a red. Okay, there is a the inner boundary is marked with a red color. Okay, that will be considered as a image A. And we have a structuring element B with a green circle. Okay, now what will be the basic first operation we will be performing? It is erosion. Okay, like look at this one, erosion, A erosion B, because I am performing this full equation on an image. Which image? A image. The A image will be a triangle and B will be your structuring element. It okay, in the first picture you can see here. Okay, the structuring element, it will be start rolling. Okay, it will be start rolling throughout your triangle. means which operations you are performing here, you are performing erosion. Erosion in the sense, wherever the common content with respect to the image and the structuring element is there, that you retain it. If it is there, like a one, there is any uncommon area will be there, that will be removed. Okay, which is the uncommon area for this one? This will be okay. Hope you can see here now. Okay, this will be like a portion will be there, that will be removed out here in the beginning. Okay, now how the circle will be rolling? Okay, the structuring element has to be rolled on an image. How it will be getting rolled? Okay, now let us come to this point. Okay, again, this is a common point. Okay, this is a edge point. I hope you can see gulfs. Okay, that is a smooth. Okay, this edge will be get removed out because it is not covered by the structuring element. There is no not match, means fully not covered by the structuring element. It will be get removed. Okay, now when I remove this one, okay, again you roll your structuring element throughout the triangle. Again, when you come to this at this point, this portion will be get removed out. Okay, at the edges when you are rolling, okay, now you what, which operation you are performing? You are performing erosion here. Okay, when you are performing erosion here, I hope you can see at the edge here, you'll find a small kind of like this kind of like a bulge image. Okay, now you perform with a erosion, means you have removed that portion. Okay, this the whatever the edge will be there, okay, the sharp edges will on the image, that will be get removed. Okay, and the bulges will be occurred here. Okay, that is the first operation we are performing. A, okay, erosion, P. Okay, now the next operation, now this is the output operation. What you get here? A, erosion, B. Now what is the next technique we have to perform? Dilation. The dilation in the sense, again you roll this image, okay, there is a circle on image. Okay, when you roll it here, okay, the full area will be get dark. It will be get dark here. Okay, means it is as good as you perform, okay, opening on an image by using the equation A, erosion B, next dilation, whatever the outcome from for the image. Okay, this is what the operation of a opening we are performing on an image. Hope you understood this one. Now let us consider with in detail how we will performing here. Okay, by considering the image here. Okay, this is an image what it is visible here. This is an image, kind of image what is given here. Okay, it will be something like a mechanical element will be given in the form of like an image. Okay, and we have a structuring element similar with a circle. You just start roll it. In this here, okay, in the first picture you can see, you just start roll it here, okay, where did the, okay, now this all, okay, uncommon area will be get removed out, and you'll get here. Okay, now I hope you can see there is a sharp edge here, this one. Okay, now I'll consider. Okay, there is a sharp edge here at this point, this point, this point, this point, this one, this one, this one. All will be get has to be removed. Okay, when you're removing, be careful that, okay, wherever it is getting matched, fully matched with the structuring element, you retain it. Otherwise you have to remove it, because I am performing a first operation with the erosion. Okay, when similarly, that is what the structuring element, when you're moving on an image, okay, roll it on an image, you will find a image like this. I hope you can have the visible output. Okay, is visible, and you will find a smooth curve inside this. And this portion, okay, there is a middle portion, the connecting portion has been removed. Okay, why? Because there is some portion is uncommon. Okay, means the image will be get removed, okay, totally removed. So since I obtained, okay, the two image from this one, A and the B image. Okay, means I mean to say, there is not two separate images here, same image is here. The image, okay, image will be get formed with the two separate structures. One first structure, second structure. Okay, now you perform A, okay, erosion B. Now I have to perform a dilation here. Again, what in the dilation, what you do? Again, you roll this by using the whatever the circle, you roll it. Okay, when you're rolling it here, all the bulges. Okay, now I hope you can see there are sharp edges here, in here, all will be get like this. Okay, bulge kind of thing. Okay, when you roll it here, you'll find the full image will be something look like this. Similarly, you will get an image in this fashion. Okay, I hope in the all the boundary, okay, in a boundary you can see the bulges. Okay, this is one of the basic operations we are performing by using a opening. Okay, now let us consider the next algorithm is closing. Okay, the closing will be exactly the reverse operations what we are performing on the opening. In the closing, I hope in the closing, okay, you can see A, there is a structuring element B. Okay, now circle, you just fill it here. When you fill it here, which operations it will be considered? It is considered as a closing. Okay, A circle, you fill this content of the circle, it will be closing equation. Okay, when you consider, I told it is exactly the reverse operations what we are performing with respect to the opening. Okay, what operation you are performing with respect to the structuring element? First you perform dilation, then later you perform erosion. Okay, is the thing clear here with respect to the closing? Okay, now that is what it is given in the form of like a sentence. Dilate A by B and then erode the result by B. In other words, closing is a group of points which intersection of object B around them with object A is not empty. Okay, now I hope the equation will be very much clear for you for to understand. Okay, opening and the closing. Okay, they are not the combined operation, they are the separate operations, opening and the closing. Okay, now look at the example again. In this, I consider an image here. Okay, this will be your image, that is the A image. Okay, now what you are performing here? First here, dilation. When you are performing a dilation operation, means the all this one, okay, the structuring element, okay, you need to be dilate, okay, you need to be fill this one content. Okay, when you filling it this one, okay, like look at this one, this is your A B and this is your image A. Okay, you just roll it on the outer circle, outer here. Okay, now when you're rolling it here, this is the edge you'll find. Okay, in the edge, the portion will be get removed out. That is what you perform a erosion here. Okay, before that, okay, that is the whatever the white portion you can see, there is like a image, white image will be there. First, I need to perform with respect to A, B, dilate. Okay, when you're dilating, this will be get filled out. Okay, this will be get filled out. Okay, means this all portion will be get filled out. Okay, and next what you are performing here? Erosion. Okay, when you perform the dilation, this the portion that in the edge here, that is unfilled portion, that will becomes as a bulge. Okay, in the negative, okay, that is what erase. Okay, whenever you are finding a erosion here, okay, that is a unfilled, there is unfilled area, it will be get filled with a black. Okay, this is exactly the reverse operations we will be performing by using a structuring element. Okay, now look at this one. Okay, when we are considered with respect to the image, Now there is the same image what we consider for like a opening. We have a image A. We will roll the structuring element B throughout the image. Now the very first basic operation what we'll be performing is a dilation, means the image has to get thick. Okay, thick means the now earlier you can see there is a just by looking at the observing on an image. Okay, all the boundary will be get added with the extra boundary here. Okay, look at this one. This is the inner portion will be there. Inner portion. There is the original image, and the outer portion will be get added. That is because of dilation. Okay, this is all. Okay, there is a one layer will be get formed on an image. That layer is because of what? Okay, the because of a dilation. Okay, that is the first operations what we are performing, dilation. Okay, now when we get here, okay, now this is the previous the boundary what you have added here. Okay, now it is empty. It will be get filled with the structuring element. So how when it is filling here, whatever the content of this one, it will be get copied here. Since I will find the complete image like this. It was empty. Okay, now it will be get thick. Okay, thick like this. Thick. Okay, since okay, because the first will be like one outer layer will be formed. In the outer layer, we need to fill it. Okay, that will be what the our image what you obtained here, that is A dilation B. Okay, now I have performed a dilation technique. Now what we have to do the erosion here by using what? Structuring element. Okay, what is the structuring element here? Same structuring element. You just take a structuring element will be B, that is nothing but a circle with a dot. You just roll it. When you roll it here, okay, now all the edges, I hope you can see there is a bulge here. This is a bulge here. Again, that will be get removed out. And the image will be get thin. Okay, there is like unwanted portion which are occurred on an image on the boundary side. That will be removed, unwanted portions. Okay, so since I will find a complete image from this one. Okay, I hope just you look at the at this point. This is a very much thick. Okay, now after the erosion, it will be get a thin here. Okay, this way, this is you may find what the operations we are performing. This is a this is most used for the operations for like a image reconstruction. Okay, for the purpose of reconstruction, for the recognition, it is the most used technique. Okay, this is what I hope you can see. Okay, now when we are performing, okay, that is what the erosion here. All the boundary portion that will be get removed here, and you will find very much sharp image at the boundary on the image outer side. Okay, this is what the basic algorithms will be running. Okay, by using your opening and the closing technique. Okay, I hope this basic operation is very much clear for you. For the purpose of understanding, okay. This is like opening and closing. Other operations can be used to construct filters, okay, which are used similarly with respect to the previous discussion on spatial filtering. A few of the spatial filtering techniques we have used here. Similar way we can use the basic opening and closing also. Especially for the like a fingerprint recognition or face recognition, or in an image, if you want to get recognized the eye of a person, or recognition through eye, then iris recognition. Okay, for the application purpose we are using. Okay, hence the noise manifest itself as a random light elements on a dark background and as dark elements on the light components of the fingerprint for the applications of fingerprint recognition. Okay, the basic the objective is to eliminate the noise and its effects on the print while distorting it as a little as possible for the finger operations. Since the morphological filter consisting of opening and closing to be most used for the purpose of recognition on an image process. Okay, hope you understood. Okay, this is the basic operations will be most used. Okay, for the pre-processing on an image application purpose. Okay, hope you understood this one. Okay, thank you.